What's up, guys? Void here from View the Void, and today we're going to be talking about substats for your gear. If you don't already know, once a piece of gear reaches grade SR or higher, it's gifted with 3 random substats, and I'm basically going to be in this video explaining to you, first of all, what substats are, why they're important, and how to change them on any given piece of gear if you've already, you know, invested quite a bit of time into it. So what I've done is I've compiled 3 different charts, which will essentially serve as a tier list to show you what the best substats are in every situation. So with that being said, let's get right into it. Okay, so what are substats? Substats are additional stats that come on any item that is S or higher. Grade S items have 1, R items have 2, SR and UR both have 3. So if you look at this Elven bow, for example, and scroll down, just below the soul crystals there, you'll see critical damage increase rate, penetration, and attack speed increase rate. And these stats here, of course, are what I'm referring to when I use the word substats. Now, it's important to note that no 2 items have the same substats, even if they are the same item. If you look here at this light crossbow and scroll down, you see Adina gain increase, EXP gain increase, and accuracy, which is completely different from the Elven bow that I have here. That brings us to the next question: how do you change them? Well, what you do is you click on the item you want to change, click Forge, change substats, and it actually does take red diamonds to re-roll it. Again, when you roll it, it'll be completely random, and there is no way currently to lock in a specific stat that you would like to keep. And so I would just kind of, as an advice, if you're just starting off in this game, generally speaking, the weapon is going to want to be the primary and first thing that you change the substats on if you don't already have a good roll. This game is all about resources, and if you don't have a way to make resources while you're AFK farming, you're really not going to be able to pull in enough Adina to improve the rest of your gear. And so really invest in a good roll on your weapon first and foremost, and then you can use the resources that you get from that weapon to bolster and make better the rest of your gear. Also, as a note, please do not attempt to reroll any item if it is lower than SR grade, because S grade items only have 1 substat and R grade items only have 2 substats, and it just simply is not worth it to use red diamonds on those items. Okay, so why are substats important? Substats are important because they can literally be the difference between you getting stunned and dying in a PvP scenario, or actually resisting that stun and escaping. And for PvE, they can be the difference between you making 5 million Adina over the course of a day, or only 500,000 Adina over the course of a day. So needless to say, they're extremely important. Okay, so getting right into it, the first set that we're going to look at is the PvP set. And if you look over on the right hand side at the legend or the key, I have categorized each substat for each item in different tiers. Green being essential, absolutely necessary if you want to be competitive in PvP. Blue being good, which you can blend with the absolutely necessary stats in green. Beige being stats that are passable if you're low on reds and you just want to kind of settle for something. And gray being absolutely useless for PvP. So, as I said, I'll provide a little bit of commentary for justification for each thing. But for the weapon, you will absolutely need attack speed and crit damage increase. Absolutely necessary. Any of the blue substats, you can mix with it. If you're, you know, a physical damage dealer, you'll want P attack. If you're a magic damage dealer, you'll want M attack. And then, of course, any of the other stats are decent. But again, you must absolutely have the 2 at the top. Those are 100% mandatory for PvP. For the helmet, abnormal status resist is going to be a theme throughout all of these items. You want to stack as much abnormal status resist as possible. What that does is that prevents you from being stunned or knocked down or poisoned or slowed or anything. It'll just straight up resist it. And so the more abnormal status resist, the better. That is a tier 1 substat for PvP. And of course, you can mix that with any of the below stats. For the chest, you want movement speed. Movement speed is incredibly important in PvP for positioning and escaping. So you're going to want movement speed and then any variation of the ones below. For the gloves, there actually isn't a mandatory stat. The blue ones are the best stats. The best stats are going to be higher up. And so if you want to look at them in terms of tiers, I have done them in terms of better to worse from top to bottom. For the boots, you know, it's kind of killer, these double absolutely necessary stats. It's going to take a lot of red diamonds, but again, it's worth it. So for the boots, attack speed increase, the faster you attack, the more damage you do, and movement speed. Being able to maneuver and get out of the way is important, and then any variation of the below stats. For the necklace, and you'll notice for all of the accessories, you must have abnormal status resist on all of them. People would say, oh, you need HP drain. No, you don't. You need to have abnormal status resist. It's the difference between you getting stunned and dying and you resisting it and escaping. So for the necklace, you want abnormal status resist, and it also gives you attack speed. The faster you attack, the more damage you deal. For earrings, abnormal status resist and movement speed, again, positioning. And then for the rings, abnormal status resist, and you actually have some flexibility for the other stats, so the rings are generally easier to roll over against the other accessories there. Okay, so moving along to the PvE or farming set specifically for use with your elite and magic gear. We'll begin with the weapon. It is absolutely necessary to have a good elite and or magic weapon, depending on what level you are and what type of monsters you're killing in the elite dungeon. You must have a good weapon with at least attack speed increase, and if you can get it, crit damage increase is also going to be pretty much essential, because it'll bolster the amount of damage that you do and will net you more resources. If you look at the asterisks there for Adina gain isn't absolutely necessary. But if you can get Adina gain, that's going to be the best roll for you. If you get HP drain or crit rate, don't sweat it. That would be okay as well. And then I just want to make a quick point. For the helmet, chest, gloves, boots, etc., all the way through accessories, the rest of these are just a commodity. As long as you have the weapon, you will be able to farm effectively and efficiently, but the rest of these are just going to bolster it by that much more. And especially for the accessories, you already should have the majority of those guaranteed stats, and you do not need to make a separate accessory set just for farming, because it would just take way too much Adina, and a lot of people obviously don't have that. So if we just go here in sequence, the helmet, Adina gain is tier 1, and HP drain is also going to be tier 1 for keeping you alive. Hopefully you have HP drain on at least another piece of gear from your PvP set to keep you alive, because you can't farm if you're dead. Moving on to the chest, Adina gain is tier 1. If you can get EXP gain or movement speed, that would be great as well. The gloves, Adina gain is tier 1, and EXP gain, if you can get it, that would be helpful. For the boots, it is absolutely necessary, and you should already have this from your PvP set, to get attack speed. Adina gain is secondary, as well as EXP gain and movement speed are going to be kind of secondary as well. The necklace, you should already have this from your PvP set. You must have attack speed, because again, the faster you kill, the more money and more resources you acquire. And for the earrings, again, you should have this from your PvP set as well, movement speed. The rings, are you can be a little bit more lenient. Hopefully, when you rolled for your PvP set, you were able to at least get one or two items with HP drain on them, which again will contribute to you staying alive while you're AFK farming. And moving on finally to the boss set, I actually questioned if this was necessary at all, but for those of you who are super into the late game and you're just bored at this point and you just want to make, you know, the best items to fight bosses with, whether it be a world boss or clan dungeons, and you want to get that last hit or, you know, do the most damage and make the most Adina from the clan dungeons, here it is. So the weapon, attack speed increase, crit damage increase, and that's going to be the consistent theme across all weapons. If you get HP drain, it's going to keep you alive, and that's good. Moving on to the helmet, HP drain to keep you alive as well. Chest, movement speed to get to and from and evade the boss attacks. And gloves, skill cooldown decrease is okay. Really, all of those are going to be fine. Boots, attack speed increase and movement speed. Necklace, attack speed at least. Earrings, movement speed at least. And for the rings, again, if you have HP drain, that would be helpful, but any of those stats will be sufficient. Again, I really questioned if this was necessary at all, but there it is. All right, so there it is. I hope that was helpful for you guys to see every possible variation for every item. If you have any stipulations or you want to butt heads about whether one stat is better than another stat, I would be more than happy to engage with you in the comment section below. So leave something down there and give me a piece of your mind if you disagree or have any constructive criticism for me. Also, pro tip! I should have mentioned this from the very beginning, okay? If you're making multiple items for limit breaking or you're starting a new accessory set, like for example, I have my hero set here, which is coming along nicely. Let's see, hopefully I don't die in the dungeon. But here we go. Everything's like almost maxed out and the limit breaks are coming along. While you're limit breaking, you're gonna be making SR items, and again, because all of the items are random, you want to wait, like get everything to SR and just wait before you start enhancing. Don't just go nuts on the first one that you find. Get a few of them, right? Get a few of them, and then you'll have like five different SR rings to pick from, because one of them might already have a perfect roll, and you will save yourself a crap ton of red gems. So if you're starting a new set, if you're not in too deep already with one set that you've been working on, you know, wait. Just wait. Don't re-roll unless you absolutely need to. So I hope that's a helpful pro tip. And let's put on my other set before I die. Okay. All right, anyway, I hope that was helpful for you guys. If you guys did enjoy, please remember to like, share, comment, and subscribe for more helpful and informative videos that serve as your guide to the world of Lineage 2 Revolution. Enjoy your day.